Yeah, let's be honest. I'll probably do this shit until they separate my consciousness. Everything is fear. Doper than I was this time just last year. Yeah, yeah, and I know you see me work em. I don't go a day without love, ain't nothing certain. You just let it do what it do, it ain't working. And you don't leave your seat till I'm fucking...
What's up, hip-hop heads and horror fans? This is your host, Seven Octoberz. Welcome to Nightmare on Sedgwick Avenue, my video blog, where I combine my two favorite cultures, or two top favorite cultures, should I say, hip-hop and horror. So today, I'm going to be doing a horror movie review for The Night House, which dropped this year. And honestly, it was one of my favorite horror films of this year. So let's get right into it. Before I start talking about the cast, the premise, what I loved about it, let's get into the trailer. I'll play that for you guys. So let's go right here. I'm going to play for you guys. So you guys, if you guys haven't seen it, here's a trailer. And then FYI, I do a lot of spoilers. So if you haven't seen the film, you probably want to wait to watch the film first and then come back to the video. So let's go. And then again, I do not own this trailer. Just playing it for purposes of reviewing the film.
Houses wherein men have lived and died are haunted houses. Through the open doors, the harmless phantoms on their errands glide, with feet that make no sound upon the floors. We meet them at the doorway, on the stair, along the passages. They come and go, palpable impressions on the air, a sense of something moving to and fro.
I really love this trailer in the era where most of the trailers give out the movie. It's probably one of the films that I love the trailer, like I said, because in the era where like they show like the whole entire movie in the trailer, I love that this one just had little parts, like the more intriguing parts of the movie, and it kind of left it up in the air. It didn't really say what it was going to be about, and that's what intrigued me about it. So I did have high expectations. I try not to go in with high expectations in horror movies, but this one was one of the ones I saw the trailer and I was just blown away. But I was pleasantly not surprised, because I wasn't surprised. I already had a feeling it was going to be dope. But yeah, it was. It met my expectations. So pretty much The Night House dropped this year, I believe in August, is what the trailer said. Yeah, August. And the director is David Bruckner. Original screenplay is by Ben Collins and Luke Petrowski, is how you pronounce it, I believe. The cast mainly is held down by Rebecca Hall, who is also not just an actress, but she's a director, screenwriter. She's come out in films like such as The Prestige, The Town, Iron Man 3, The Gift, and one of the latest films she's been in recently as well was Godzilla vs. Kong. So she's a great actress. Really love her in this film. She, like, pretty much her performance, she blew it out the water. Great performance. One of the main reasons why I love this film, her performance was so great. She plays Beth. Her husband died of, or not died, but he pretty much committed suicide, who is named Owen in the film and is played by Evan Janikit, I believe is the last name, how you pronounce it. Claire is her best friend, or close friend, who is played by Sarah Goldberg. And then we get Mel, who is her neighbor, who's played by Vondi Curtis Hall. So pretty much we have just a little bit of characters. Like I said, Rebecca is the main character of this film. The premise of it, you couldn't really tell from the trailer, but pretty much Beth has become a widow. As mentioned, her husband Owen committed suicide. So she's dealing with grief, depression. She turns to alcohol to escape her reality. She's kind of shocked as far as the fact that he committed suicide. She didn't really see the signs. They also show that she's a teacher, so she kind of is kind of just going, hitting rock bottom. And Claire, her friend, is really concerned about her, so she ends up going to the lake house that you saw in the trailer. She has this beautiful lake house, very isolated, in the middle of the woods, so she's kind of even more alone. So I love the themes that this movie touches on, from isolation, depression, suicide, alcoholism, near-death experience, life after death, what is, what isn't, what exists after it, reincarnation, you know, resurrection, what is there after that. So again, in one of the scenes, Claire comes and visits Beth to try to get her to leave the lake house, because again, it's an isolated place. She kind of wants her to come over to her house so she's not alone and dealing with her grief. And in the conversation they have, she kind of speaks about her having actually depression, that she's actually the one that was depressed, not Owen, and feeling guilty, thinking that maybe some of her negativity got passed on to him, and that's why he killed himself. So she feels a lot of guilt as well. And then there was a note, a suicide note he left, which said, you were right. There is nothing. Nothing is after you. You're safe now, is what the note said. And she just kept replaying that note. It's kind of a really deep scene and really awkward scene as well. But it was really well done by Rebecca, where she goes out with Claire and the rest of the teachers on some like drinking night out. They're trying to, you know, Claire invites her to try to get her to like get out of her depression and grief. And it's so awkward because she brings up that note of her husband, a suicide note, and it just kind of gets dark from there. And kind of the people that are there at the bar are kind of like freaked out a little bit. But I just really like the fact that how she played like someone really going through grief. And it was just, like I said, well, great performance. So that scene is really like one of the ones that stood out to me. Again, I love the fact that they didn't use like the regular like trope of the jump scares. It was like really subtle. And the way it was filmed too was like really ominous. So I like the scenes where Beth has like some like visions, and she sees like women running through the forest, and they kind of go right through her. So she's kind of seeing like a vision. I don't know what it is, but it was just really cool. And that kind of like stuff like that was just kind of like scares out of nowhere. I loved it because it wasn't like on purpose. It went with the scene. So I really loved that because it did scare me. I think one or two times I did get like, it made me jump. I was like, oh shit, I didn't see that coming. The cinematography was really beautiful as well. The setting, the location of the lake house is a beautiful setting. Like the colors that they use, like at nighttime especially, like it was kind of like neon, vibrant colors. Like you could tell from the cover right here with like the red neonish colors and other colors that they used. It was really, really dope. I loved how they used that. And then again, like I said, the themes that it touched on, Rebecca's performance, again, she outdid herself, but pretty much when she's also talking to Claire and kind of having a deep conversation with her, she tells, Beth tells Claire that she actually had a car accident where she died for 4 minutes, and she came back. But when she was technically dead, she realized that there was nothing after death, like there was nothing. And that she had told that story to Owen before he passed away. And Owen kind of was trying to convince her that, no, there's more to after death, pretty much. Like, I don't know if he wanted to convince her that there was like a heaven or something like that, not just pure nothing. But he was close to convincing her, and then he ends up like committing suicide. So Beth goes down this like rabbit hole. She goes and finds old pictures and all this stuff. She's trying to see what caused Owen to kill himself, and she kind of goes down this like this mystery of her finding out like that he was with some women and all this stuff. And then pretty much it turns out like she finds out these floor plans, they're identical to their lake house, and it's just in reverse. And it's pretty much another identical lake house, just in reverse across the way of where they live. And pretty much, again, spoilers from here, she pretty much discovers that nothing is actually like a demonic sort of entity. And Owen found out that this entity was kind of trying to latch onto Rebecca's character, Beth. When she died for those 4 minutes, it kind of latched onto her, and she kind of cheated death type of thing. So I take it as not even a demon. Nothing is more of the Reaper, death. Maybe she escaped death and she wasn't supposed to, kind of like a final destination type of thing. And that nothing has been wanting her, but Owen finds out and kind of starts creating this other house that's, like I said, identical to their lake house. He starts luring these women that look like Beth to try to trick the nothing entity to believe that that's Beth, and nothing catches on to what's going on. I think he kind of possesses Owen. It's kind of like iffy in that aspect. I don't know if he actually possessed them, and that's why he started killing all these women, but it doesn't look like it. I think he was just sacrificing these women. So Owen was sacrificing these women so nothing didn't go after his wife Beth, but then it kind of backfires on him. Nothing figures out the plan. He's been tricked, and then that's he kind of pretty much has Owen kill himself. I don't know if he kind of like possesses him or how that happens again, because it's not too clear in the movie, but that's my interpretation of it. And pretty much Beth then finds all this out. She has an altercation with nothing, which is like it's kind of like the invisible man, pretty much. It's nothing there. You can just see the figure. And she pretty much doesn't escape him. Like at the end of the movie, again, spoiler, he's still, the nothing entity is still there. So is there going to be a sequel? I don't know. Honestly, like, I love this film, so I like it how it is. I wouldn't really want a sequel. I think it's great the way it was left open-ended. But if there is a sequel, I just hope maybe Rebecca comes back to play Beth. So again, beautifully shot for me. Like, the vibes I got from this movie, it reminded me a lot of, like I said, The Invisible Man, the one that just came out recently, mixed with What Lies Beneath, and a mixture of like Inception, just because of the cinematography, the way they filmed it. It was just like really intricate and just like beautifully done. Like, everything about this film I loved. Again, they said that, like, the colors that they used, vibrant colors at nighttime. Other things, what else? Like I said, like, it being in the middle of nowhere made it even creepier. That's why it kind of reminded me a lot of What Lies Beneath, like the whole lake house vibe. And it touched again on like near life, near death experience, as far as what comes after. Is there nothing? Is there, you know, resurrection, reincarnation, heaven or hell, whatever you may believe in or whatever. I love that it touched on those themes again, like also like depression, like mental health, grief. Like I said, it was beautifully shot. Rebecca killed her performance. Let me know what you guys think. I wanted to make this a little bit short, but it was one of my favorite films of this year. I think The Night House, Last Night in Soho, top two horror flicks, and they were like a mixture of genres. The Night House, it was more like a psychological horror mixed with like mystery, which I love those type of films. But yeah, I really recommend it. If you haven't seen it, hopefully you are not watching this. If you haven't seen it, because I just pretty much spoiled the movie for you, my bad. But thank you for everybody who's been watching my reviews, or if you've been watching my vlog, whatever, whichever video you've been watching, I appreciate you guys. Again, this was Nightmare on Sedgwick Avenue, a horror movie review. I hope you guys subscribe to join the journey. And subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be bringing more content, other stuff in the works. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. Have a great week or weekend whenever you're watching this. Peace.